youngest champion.
The man is incredible.
Emmitt Schmidt. Photo finish.
This is ABC Sports.
One of college football's largest crowds of the season is gathered at Michigan Stadium on this postcard day for the 27th game between Michigan and Notre Dame. Across the season, so many great players like Tim Brown have made great plays. There was the blurring speed of Rocket Ismail, startling the Wolverine, and the dazzling dancing of Desmond Howard. And today, we'll see another one named Charles.
If the ball comes my way, then it's meant for me. Every time I touch the ball, I'm thinking score.
A Wolverine will do whatever is needed to defend its turf. Charles Woodson is the lead Wolverine. And so the Fighting Irish are back in town, and that does stir the juices around this part of the country, no question about it. And if you have been reading the Notre Dame press lately, you might get the feeling that the sky is falling. But that's not true. The Irish are only wounded. A fact that the Michigan coaches have been preaching as loud as they could all week to their people. That wounded they may be, they come to town dangerous and still talented. And to pursue the point now with Bob Greasy.
Well, Keith, whenever you are wounded and you're down, you turn to your leaders. Bob Davey has got to motivate this team, and Ron Paulus, fifth-year senior, making his 36th start of the year. The offense is in transition. He has to play well for the offense to do well. They are 105th in the nation in offense, going against Michigan, the number one defense in the nation, led by Charles Woodson. You'll see Charles Woodson on defense, you'll see him on offense, and you'll see him on special teams. And don't be surprised if the key play in this game is not in the kicking game.
Touch the Go Blue sign and the band roaring in the crowd of 100,000 plus, and the blue skies of late September. Pretty good setting for what we're about to see. The Notre Dame-Michigan series history goes back 110 years, but they haven't played that many times, as you can see. This will be the 27th meeting. Notre Dame has had success over the last 4 years, winning three out of the four. The last time they played was 1994 at South Bend, and Michigan won that one. So it's been a tight, tough series, with the games in the main having been pretty close. There was one that got away from Michigan, Notre Dame winning it 26-7 at one time, but Michigan accommodated them with seven turnovers. So it's been a series where the kicking game and the turnovers and those kind of things have had great meaning. On the field on a very pleasant afternoon is our colleague Lynn Swan.
Thank you very much, Keith. You know, the history of this rivalry says that special teams always plays a dramatic role, and in many years, a deciding role. In 1982, Anthony Carter almost down at midfield, found his balance and the end zone. But it was in 1986 as Notre Dame's John Carney missed the field goal to the left. Michigan prevailed. And in 1989, the Rocket, Rocky Ishmael, returned not one but two kickoffs for touchdowns and a Notre Dame victory. And in 94, with only 7 seconds remaining, Remy Hamilton kicked his fourth field goal for a Wolverine two-point victory. And in today's ball game, of course, number two, Charles Woodson, is a man that can have that special team's impact, but don't count Notre Dame out. Number 15, Alan Rossum, a small man who plays on the defensive secondary, also an excellent special teams player on the returns. Keith?
I wouldn't be surprised to see Rossum like Woodson on the other side of the ball today, playing both ways. So from Ann Arbor, let's switch for a moment to our New York studio and John Sunder. All right, John, thanks very much. We've just had the flip of the coin out of the center of the field with the referee Jim Kimberling conducting it. And it will be Notre Dame receiving. So Bob Davie, in his fourth game, having succeeded Lou Holtz as the head coach of the Fighting Irish, will get the ball first. The Irish beat Georgia Tech to start the season, then lost successively to Purdue and Michigan State. Lloyd Carr is in his third season here at Michigan as the head coach. Came here first in 1980, rose to defensive coordinator, succeeded Bo Schembechler as the head coach. He's 21-8, including wins over Colorado and Baylor this season. Lloyd, however, is 9-0 in games played in September in his 3 years.
He'd like to play the whole season in September.
He would, yeah.
Michigan has won the toss. They elected to defer possession of the ball to the second half. So the Wolverines will kick it off. So it's Michigan kicking off to Notre Dame. Wolverines ranked sixth in the nation. The Notre Dame offensive front will be one that we will watch very carefully today, to see whether or not they can contain the aggressiveness of a Michigan defense that was really impressive in the first two games they played. Jay Feely will kick off for Michigan. Waiting for it. It is Driver, Tony Driver, waiting for it. And Driver, a freshman, waits for the ball to go back over his head and beyond the field of play. So here's that offensive front now for Notre Dame. It's relatively sound tackle to tackle, but zone blocking can't account for everything. The receivers, they lack foot speed, and they need some people to step up and make some plays for them. Bobby Brown has, however, caught 21 passes in three games. In the backfield, Ron Paulus has been steady, but there is a lack of health and wisdom at tight end and fullback, and that has hurt the running game. From the 20, then, it's first down for the Irish in the white shirts. That's Brown in motion coming to the bottom of the picture. Paulus turns and hands the ball to Denson, and Autry Denson slashes over the left side and picks up 5 yards. The Michigan defensive front needs to penetrate today. They must apply pressure. They must open the door for the linebackers, that whole front seven. And a lot of confidence comes for the linebackers from their Colorado ball game. Eric Mays can be a wrecking ball. The defensive backs, perhaps the best secondary in the country. And Notre Dame figures to play away from Charles Woodson today. Second down and 5 for the Irish.
Unbalanced line, Keith.
To the top of the picture, handed inside to Denson. Denson is taken down this time, and the man that got him was Josh Williams. Took his feet right out from under him with help from Rob Rennes.
Here's a look. Notre Dame offense, only 13 points per game. That's 105th in the nation. Michigan defensively leads the nation. They've only given up 2 field goals, 1 in each game.
Ball is on the 26-yard line. It is 3rd down and 4 for Notre Dame. Ball is with a long count. And a whistle, and he counted too long.
But Keith, I like what he's doing, though. Ron Paulus. 2 weeks ago, we were here, saw Michigan time their blitzes perfectly. Now it looks like Ron's coming out, and he's varying his snap count. Quick count before, a long count there. Of course, you don't want to be charged with a delay of game, but I like what I'm seeing early with Paulus changing up the count.
Delay of game on the offense. Repeat, we're down.
So take away the 5-yard penalty, and you're looking at 3rd down and 9.
Take a look at from behind the defense. Look at the linebackers moving. 26, that's Mays. 93, that's Sword. They're blitzing. They may not be blitzing, but don't let them time their blitz perfectly where they're going to get across the line of scrimmage.
They're creeping.
Here they come.
Now they go, and Paulus, looking around, is flushed out of the pocket and taken down at the 30 and just over the 30 and gets a first down on the run. They flushed him all right, got the pressure on him, but he had some room up the middle, and he picks up the Notre Dame first down.
They had a blitz coming up, the two linebackers coming up the middle, but it was picked up very nicely. 28 there is Barry, the fullback, and then Ron says, all right, I've got a huge hole. I know I need so much for a first down. I can get it. Big first down for Notre Dame.
He's keeping the linebackers quiet. Gives the ball to Denson. Denson is hit with some impact. Marcus Ray, number 29, was right up in the middle of the mix at about the 32-yard line. Glenn Steele, 81, Josh Williams, 91, and Rob Rennes, the down three. And then you add to it Copenhager and Hall and Mays and Sword. That's a very quick group. Second down and nine for the Irish. And in motion is Nelson. Makai Nelson. Give the ball away to Tim Barry, the fullback. And he will lose 2 yards back inside the 30. The umpire today is Ed Manning. Ed Peters is the linesman. Line judge is Tom Hoffman. Field judge Tom Bryan. Side judge Tom Clark. And the back judge is Scott Helverson. It's an all Big Ten group. Third and 11. Three wide out. With time, his pass was away, a penalty flag is thrown, and it is incomplete. Malcolm Johnson running under the ball. The referee, Jim Kimberling, threw the penalty flag, looking right at the quarterback. It may be a holding call. Nope, procedure. If they decline it, it'll be fourth down, 11.
Keith, it's important for Bob Davies' crew to get off to a good start. They come in, as you mentioned early on, wounded. I think their confidence level is not as high as it should be, and they can't afford to get behind in this game early.
Michigan's about to get their hands on the ball as Charles Woodson goes back under the punt from Hunter Smith. Jim Kimberling's flag is still laying back there on the ground. He goes and gets it. He may need that.
He won't forget that flag. An official without a flag, you never heard of that.
He's unarmed. Woodson is standing back just inside the 35-yard line. Smith's kick is a low line drive. It's going to bounce. It goes sideways, and Woodson is unable to get to it. And the Michigan will have its first possession beginning at about its 34-yard line. So here is the chilly starting lineup for the Michigan Wolverines. They get Zach Adamy back at center, and getting Zach will help the young line that has been holding up well and growing weekly. The receivers include tight end Jeremy Tooman, six catches, averaging right at 25 yards a catch. Ty Sheets is yet to step up. The backs, good receivers here too, especially Clarence Williams and Chris Howard. So officially call it the 34, and that's where they begin as Brian Greasy turns and gives the ball away to Chris Howard, and he's across the 35 to the 36. The Irish defense along the front, they're hurting. 7 of 9 from last year injured or graduated. Number 90, Lance Legree, for example, has never played nose guard before this season. The linebackers, they have not been able to stop the run, which reduces your linebackers' opportunity to attack. And the defensive secondary, there's experience there and proven people, but without some front pressure, those DBs are kind of hanging out there. And they have been. Covington and Rossum are relatively small physically. Gracie back, looks quickly and throws quickly, and the pass is incomplete. The pass was intended for Russell Shaw, number 4. Ty Sheets was going down the sidelines on a fly. So here are the numbers for the Michigan starting quarterback, Brian Greasy. Had a very good games to start the season. Now into the lineup for Michigan comes number 7, Chris Floyd. He is the better of the blocking backs. And the Wolverines will go to a two-back set now, with Floyd and Howard behind Greasy. And passing with time. The pass thrown to the sidelines. It is completed to Howard, and Howard is up to about the 40. But that is short of a first down, so they'll be looking at third and about three.
The Irish had good coverage, Keith, downfield, and Greasy had to come off to the short man. You don't want to throw it underneath on third and eight or nine, but nobody was open downfield. Good coverage.
Make it fourth and three, not third and three, as I called it. Jason Benson now, who was a walk-on from Troy, Michigan, has been averaging almost 45 yards on seven punts this season. And he's got another good one in the air, going down the sidelines, and it goes straight out of bounds. So Alan Rossum, who had backed up under the punt like Charles Woodson, unable to get his hands on it and do anything with it. And so Notre Dame takes over the football, first down at their own 22. Next week, America's biggest roadshow will go to Tallahassee, Florida. College football doubleheader at noon Eastern. Miami is at Florida State. And then the regional coverage includes Iowa at Ohio State at 3:30 Eastern, Notre Dame, Stanford, Texas A&M, and Colorado. Check your local listings for the game in your area. So these two heralded punt returners have been denied an opportunity so far after a possession by each team. And the Irish come with a single back set, two wide receivers to the top. And Denson is hit at about the 24-yard line. Autry Denson is a junior from Lauderhill, Florida.
Notre Dame wants to do is come out and run right at Michigan. They don't want to get into a situation like Michigan had 2 weeks ago against Colorado, where they were flying all over the place, throwing the ball around, and Michigan's speed was taking an advantage. They want to run right at him, neutralize the speed of that Michigan defense, and see if they can stop a power Big Ten type of attack running right at you.
Second down and eight from the 24. And Bobby Brown goes in motion. Ed Denson is finding a little bit of room as he works his way out near the 29. And here's Lynn Swan.
Okay, one of the stories we need to be aware of about the Michigan defense is the fact that they've only been challenged up to the number of seven. Seven, the number of plays that any offense has run against them before they've taken off and let the offense get back on the field. Notre Dame's last possession, they had it six plays. Now, they expect Notre Dame to challenge them a little bit more, but one of their goals is to get the offense on the field, not themselves, Keith.
So it's third and three for the Irish. Notre Dame has had some 10, 12, and 14 snap possessions in their three games. So they can keep the ball. This one is thrown underneath. It is caught by Rakhine Nelson, and it's good for a first down. He was 1 yard past the marker. He took the ball, but Sam Sword laid a lick on him, but he kept it in his arms, and it'll be first down for the Irish.
Nice play by Ron. He had plenty of time, looked down the field, and just threw the crossing route to pick up the first down. You saw him there talking to the troops, says, all right, let's keep the ball, move it down the field.
So far, the Michigan defense has not gambled. They had some pressure in the early going when Paulus ran for the first down. They busted it that one time, but that's all. Ball is at the 34. To the side. It is caught by Nelson. Charles Woodson was there and hit him almost immediately, but it works to get the ball past the 40 to the 41.
I mentioned in the opening that Paulus is starting his 36th game. So he knows what he's doing. He knows he's throwing at Woodson. He checked in this play, saw Woodson was off. He's not going to gamble too much at Woodson. We were told that they're not going to throw at Woodson very much today. They're going to throw the other side. But that was almost a gimme, and he checked to it.
Second down and three. It's Nelson in motion. Here comes pressure. It off to Autry Denson, and he's down right on the 40-yard line, and that is a loss of a yard. We are going to see in this ball game, as the day wears on, Tony Driver, who is a 200-pound-plus freshman out of Louisville, Kentucky. And they think he's got a very bright future. He was back there under the opening kickoff but did not get the ball.
Two of the top programs in college football, Keith. They've got some top players here. We're going to see some of these freshmen today.
Third and four now for Notre Dame. Paulus's pass is away. And that'll be close to another first down. The ball was thrown hard, and Bobby Brown, who came into this ball game with 21 catches in three games, reeled that one in And it was a tough catch in front of Tommy Hendricks.
Inside receiver's going to break to the outside. You see the yardage marker at the top of your screen, just enough for a first down. Notre Dame's passing the first three games has been a short possession type passing game.
So it's first down, Notre Dame at their own 44-yard line. No score in the first quarter, and we've used half of it. And Notre Dame is doing in this game what they wanted to do. They're possessing the ball. Here's the ball coming deep. It's caught at the 22-yard line by Malcolm Johnson. Johnson got away from number 30 on that side of the field, Andre Weathers. And out ran him to the ball.
This is throwing away from Woodson. Woodson's on our right side to the top left of your screen. That's the 6'5", Malcolm Johnson, getting by Weathers. The offensive coordinator, Jim Coletta last year, trying to do what he did when he was at Purdue, and that is control the ball.
32 yards on that play. First down at about the 23-yard line. This is Autry Denson inside the 20. Just barely before Eric Mays makes the tackle. So right now, Notre Dame has been able to blunt any pressure from the Michigan defense.
Michigan's been pretty good in the first quarter through 27 consecutive regular season games. Not allowed a touchdown. Notre Dame's problem has not been moving the ball, Keith. It's been scoring points.
Second down and 7. Nelson in motion. Denson the ball. Behind the line of scrimmage by Marcus Ray, number 29. Marcus Ray, the strong safety, stepping up.
Notre Dame going with a lot of substitutions here, Keith.
Well, I think they just brought in one of those big guys at tight end, didn't they? No, they brought in the pass catcher, Jabari Holloway, replacing Ritter. He's not quite as big as Ritter, and he's a better receiver. He's also a freshman. Pressure coming. Paulus catches pass away. His man is wide open, Bobby Brown. And Brown is wrestled out of bounds down at the 7-yard line. The defensive pressure was led by Eric Mays, and he was all over Paulus, but Paulus again nimble enough to step away and find the open receiver.
Well, Paulus does a nice job of avoiding the rush. Take a look right here. 93 is Sword and 26 is Mays. It's a blitz. He drifts to his left side, or our left side, and finds Brown coming across. Nice job by the veteran Paulus to pick up the first down, keep the drive going.
And a good job by Brown to go with his scrambling quarterback.
Yeah, well, he was coming across.
And first and goal for the Irish. Denson. To the 4.
It's a good, solid tackle by Marcus Ray. He called his name a little earlier. He's third on this team in tackles and was up in the leaders last year in tackles. He's just a very good safety.
Glenn Steele came to the sideline just a moment ago for Michigan.
Single coverage up at the top.
Denson has the ball, has a yard, the penalty flag. So Steele is off the field right now for the moment for Michigan. Joaquin Fazell replaces him along the defensive front, and the penalty call is against Notre Dame.
Flags will kill you, Keith. Carr knows what it's like. They lead the Big Ten in the number of penalties, but Bob Davey says we get down there, a good drive, opening, get a holding penalty, 10 yards back. Notre Dame has only been ahead 11 minutes in all three of their games, Keith. Of 180 minutes they've played, they've only been ahead 11 minutes. And that's tough when you're playing catch-up and you're playing from behind.
So the 10-yard penalty moves the ball back outside the 15-yard line, just barely. An 11-yard penalty, so it's a second and goal. Holding being point of foul. Brown and Johnson are wide to the top of your picture. Both lanky fellows and leapers. Wallace is back looking into the end zone. The first touchdown scored against the Michigan defense this year, and Brown, who stands 6'3", and as I said, as a leaper, just simply went up and beat Weathers for the ball. Jim Sanson for the extra point. Hunter Smith.
Jim Sanson holds the extra point.
And the kick is good. At 3 minutes and 16 seconds to play in the first quarter, 12 plays, 78 yards, and it's 7-0, Notre Dame. Seven to nothing, the Irish take the lead in the first quarter, the first touchdown of the year against the Michigan defense. Numbers on the drive we gave you.
Inside receiver, number 8, Bobby Brown, working on Marcus Ray. He does a good move to get by him, then a nice adjustment to the ball to catch it. Outstanding catch. Look at the protection. Two blitzers are in there. Paulus sees it, throws it high and outside. Ron, you can't throw it any better than that.
He was 6 of 6 on the touchdown march, 77 yards and a touchdown. So the Irish will kick off now to Michigan. Notre Dame controlling the ball most of the quarter. Michigan has seen it one time. And it was 1-2-3 kick. Sanson hits it. It's Clarence Williams. And Williams is out to the 34-yard line. Almost broke it. Very close to running the distance. So Michigan getting ready to go to the offense again. ABC Sports presentation of college football is brought to you by the Pontiac Sunfire. Finally, a real set of wheels you can really afford. By the U.S. Army. Be a part of the toughest, smartest army in the world. Be all you can be. By Marriott Hotels, Resorts, and Suites. We believe when you're comfortable, you can do anything. And by Burger King, where you can get your burgers worth. Well, a couple of days ago, Dick Ash went in and put on his four stripes, became a captain out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida, stopped at Pompano Beach, picked up his Goodyear blimp, Stars and Stripes, and there he is, soaring in the blue sky. Providing some spectacular pictures, we might add. First down and 10, 3:07 to go first quarter. The ball is just beyond the 34. This is Chris Howard carrying the 215-pounder from River Rouge, Louisiana, and he picks up the better part of 5 yards on the play, make it 4, call it second down and 6. Grant Irons, a freshman linebacker, brought him down.
Last week against Baylor, Wolverines rushed for over 344 yards. Howard, Williams, and Thomas. Thomas, a true freshman, going over 100 yards for the first time.
Clarence Williams, the tailback, goes in motion. Very good receiver. Throw it back inside, trying to set up an inside screen for it. Notre Dame made it up. Well, they look like they knew that one was coming. Benny Gilbo was the first man to get there.
Michigan has done that quick screen to the wide out several times, and Greg Madison, the defensive coordinator at Notre Dame, used to be at Michigan. He's coming back, and he should know this offense pretty well, Keith.
Third down and 5.
Talking to Mike DeBoer, the Michigan offensive coordinator, he says, I know what Greg's going to do. He's going to try and stop our run.
So far, he has. To Russell Shaw for a first down just across midfield, and so the Wolverines will move the chain. put it on the Notre Dame 48-yard line where Lamont Bryant made the tackle.
Well, this was a big play for Michigan. They needed to keep the ball, Keith. They needed a first down, and Bryant gets the ball into Shaw. Big first down.
Almost dropped that snap, but he got enough of the string to turn and hand it to Chris Howard. And Howard will pick up about 3 yards. Anthony Thomas, another freshman running back wearing the Michigan colors, had a big outing last week in the win over Baylor. He went for over 100 yards, and they expect to play him quite a bit today.
Here comes Woodson.
Now Charles Woodson in for the first time on offense.
Woodson's been in 9 offensive plays for Michigan in the first 2 games, and 7 of the 9 times they went to him. Either threw it to him or handed it to him on a reverse. See if he's a decoy or they're really after him.
He's at the top of the picture. And Greasy looks at him. Now Bryant has to scramble, gets his pass away, and it is incomplete, thrown down the sidelines. And it was thrown in the direction of Jerry Mutuman, the tight end. But they covered Woodson pretty well. He was not a factor.
Well, he was a decoy this time. They faked the wide receiver screen right there, and they were going to try to go up the sideline to the tight end. You saw Miner, number 4 there, was looking for him. But good coverage by the Irish.
So it is 3rd and 7. He's still out there, and he's one of 3 wide receivers to the bottom of the picture. Out of the shotgun. Pass goes the other way, and it is caught by Ty Streets. So Ty Streets makes a play. First down, Michigan, at the Notre Dame 25.
Nice throw by Greasy and a nice catch by Streets. Notre Dame in man coverage from behind the defense. Miner, number 4, blitzing. Throws it over the linebacker. Michigan with a nice drive.
Notre Dame leading 7-0, a half a minute to go in the first quarter. Run the ball into traffic with Chris Howard. And that's 2, maybe 3 yards. Clock is rolling along, and it looks like the first quarter is going to end on that play. And it will. So after 1 period of play at the Big House in Ann Arbor, Michigan, the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame 7 and the Wolverines of Michigan 0.
On ABC Sports.
The ball is resting at the 22-yard line of Notre Dame in the possession of Michigan, 2nd down and 7, with the Irish leading 7-0. This is Michigan's first threat of the ball game. Shaw to the field. Penalty flag. And a whistle. And did they burn the clock? Or was it a false start?
Dead ball. False start.
False start.
On the offense. 5 yards. 2nd down.
One of those little ticky-tack mistakes that's worth 5 yards, but it can kill you. Instead of 2nd and 7, it's now 2nd and 12. That's the first Michigan penalty.
I mentioned they came in with 21 penalties in the first 2 games in Michigan. And Lloyd was telling us yesterday that most of them occurred on the offensive side. Illegal movement, holding. Those things stop drives.
It's Floyd. And back down close to the line of scrimmage. We got close to the 5-yard penalty back. Brought down by Melvin Dansby. Melvin is a senior out of Birmingham, Alabama.
He's the captain of that group, Keith. He's had a tough go of it. He's had knee problems as his knee drains. He doesn't get to practice as much as he would like to during the week, and he still leads this team in tackles.
Third and nine now, and they're in the shotgun. Has him. Tillman. Jeremy Tillman, the tight end. Out of bounds at the 10, first down, Michigan.
Michigan is one team that likes to go to their tight ends. Wide receivers here, wide receiver here, but no, they're going to the tight end right here, down and out, man-to-man coverage. Spread you out from one side to the next, and then throw to the tight end. Keep watched by wide receivers, watched by wide receivers, then I'll throw to my tight end on Gilbo number two.
First down and goal for Michigan. It's Floyd. To the five, to the four.
Floyd should have been hit and stopped in the backfield that time, Keith. There were two or three Notre Dame defenders in the backfield. Floyd just kept going and made a nice run out of it.
He leaned it out. He finally got in behind big old Steve Hutchinson, who laid a block.
He doesn't get to carry the ball that much either. He's the blocking fullback and a darn good one.
This is Williams. Clarence Williams' grandmother could have scored that one. Big hole up in front. Adamy and Zeman and Jensen. Now from Craig Baker. Ryan Greasy holds it, and the kick is good. So Michigan uses 11 plays, goes 66 yards, and they tie the score early in the second quarter at 7. Tony Driver, the freshman from Louisville, Kentucky, has gone deep now for Notre Dame to receive the kickoff from the Michigan Wolverines, Jay Feely. There's Driver. 200-pounder. And they feel that he can give them some speed on these kick returns and give them some field position. Here's the kick. It's a low line drive. He lets it bounce. It bounces in front of him, but he controls it. And keeps on sliding across the field. Look out! That's what they were hoping he could give them. It's first down, Notre Dame at the Michigan 45-47 yard line.
Let's go back and take a look at the touchdown. Watch the block right here, the guard on this linebacker. That's Jared Irons as he comes in. Jansen, the left tackle, is going to get a nice block. Grant Irons, the brother of Jared, number 44, gets blown out. From behind the offense, Zeman is 52, Jansen is 77. Right up at him.
It's first down, Notre Dame at the Michigan 46-yard line after Driver's 49-yard return. Ball is handed away to Audrey Denson. He cuts back against the grain and picks up about 3 yards.
Keith, Michigan's touchdown drive, very impressive. That's what good teams do. They answer a touchdown with a touchdown. Then Tony Driver for Notre Dame, the true freshman, gets some momentum right back for the Irish by running that kickoff back and getting the Irish in great field position.
Second down and 7 with 13 minutes to go in the first half. And couldn't do it, so he'll go down at the line of scrimmage. Josh Williams was there like a big oak door.
Notre Dame Notre Dame's offensive coordinator, Jim Coletto, came over from Purdue. He was the head coach of Purdue. Purdue beat Michigan last year, and they beat it by holding the football, time of possession. Purdue kept it 13 more minutes than Michigan had it. That's the scheme that Notre Dame wants to do here today. Time of possession, keep the football.
Third and seven. Little dump-off pass to Jamie Spencer. Spencer diving for the marker. The mark is going to be around the 40 and well short of the first down.
Well, this is a decision now for Bob Davey whether to go for it on fourth down or whether to punt the ball away. He's going to do the conservative, try to back Michigan up deep in their own territory.
He was looking at fourth and four. Hunter Smith in for his second punt.
And if you've got any kind of trick plays from the punt formation, not a bad area of the field to try one.
Charles Woodson standing back at the 10. Very high. Oh, look at this. It's in the end zone. Just barely, though.
Fisher got wiped out on the sideline.
Just barely trickled into the end zone. Almost went out inside.
He got wiped out.
40-yard punt. 7 Central Time. So here's the third possession of the ball game for Michigan.
And this is what Notre Dame wants. They want to keep the ball, keep it away from Michigan.
From the 20. Chris Howard, and he'll get it out across the 25. He disappeared in the pile, and when they all fell down, he picked up another yard and a half.
This is not a Big Ten game, Keith, but really both teams want to play it that way. They want to play physical, they want to run the football, and they want to control the kicking game.
Anthony Thomas has checked into the ball game now at tailback. He's the freshman for Michigan, Winfield, Louisiana. He's big at about 228 or 29, and he tries the right side, and he is stopped short of the 30. Now let's go to New York and John Saunders.
Key for Burger King, it's another look at Randy Moss, who's having another terrific day. Chad Pennington to Moss, this time just 8 yards, but it's his third touchdown reception of the day. He has 153 yards receiving, and Marshall's leading Ball State 28-16. Meanwhile, Kentucky, no match for Florida right now, 28-0 in the first quarter. Back to you, Keith.
Florida defense, Keith, may be one of the best in the nation. I mean, it is one of the best, maybe the best.
They go to Chris Floyd trying to pick up a first down, and I don't know that he made it. It does not appear from this angle that he did, because the man marking on this side has marked it short of the 30-yard line. And so Michigan may be looking at third down and a very short yardage circumstance.
Fourth down.
Yeah. The extra effort, the man came over the top and stopped him, so it is fourth down.
Brad Williams, the defensive tackle for Notre Dame, 77, just buried himself and wouldn't let the offense move him. Carr's got a decision here, does he?
He's going.
Looks like he's going to go for it, or maybe not. Quick punt. Running their guys in for a quick punt.
Let Brian kick it.
He can't kick it that far. He's a
Jason Benson spins it up. Nice tight spiral and gets the ball down to about the 33-yard line, and that's where Notre Dame will have the ball again. So the Wolverines are unable to keep possession. Presentation of college football brought to you by the Ford F-150. Strength after strength after strength. By Smith Barney, a member of the Travelers Group. Smith Barney, they make money the old-fashioned way. They earn it. By Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Dr. Pepper, this is the taste. And Best Western. Best Western, across the street from Ordinary. The Goodyear blimp, Stars and Stripes, up there providing pictures out of the sky today. Goodyear blimps now in their fourth decade. Live sports coverage. Tony Driver's on the field now in the backfield for Notre Dame. That big freshman who gave him the field position a while ago. Jamie Spencer's back there with him, and now they shift into an eye. Don Paulus, who's 7 of 8 for 80 yards and a touchdown. He's hit 7 in a row. From the 33-yard line, first down. Top man, the big fullback, Jamie Spencer, 247-pounder from Monroe, Louisiana, who's had a sore leg, picks up 2 yards. Well, got him more than that. Got him 3. Second down and 7.
Dame has the ball. Maybe 3.5 more minutes. Michigan.
Is completed to the sideline short of the first down by a couple of yards, and the ball was caught right in front of Charles Woodson by Malcolm Johnson.
It's a dangerous throw. Take a look at the pass protection, the offensive line for Ron Paulus. Ron wanted to go downfield. There were 2 receivers over there. He wanted to go downfield, and he ended up throwing it out to Johnson, number 6. This is dangerous. Throwing a slow pass, a late pass out there in Woodson's area.
Third and a long one. They'll run it and get it. Tony Driver carried the ball. And they've marked him just beyond the 43. They may want to put the chains on it to make sure. Nope. First down.
Keith, 2 guys that Notre Dame is missing on this offense, the 2 that graduated, the tight end, Kriplevich, and the fullback, Mark Edwards. Those 2 guys not only were good receivers, but terrific blockers. And run the football like Notre Dame likes to do, you have to have a good tight end blocking and good fullback blocking. And they've been a little short of that this year.
We're in a 7-7 tie here in the second quarter with 8:35 to go in the first half. They've changed the play at the line of scrimmage again. Paulus going to option down the line with Driver. And they're going to get something out of it. There's a penalty flag thrown. He's got 9 yards on the play. But let's see about the flag, and I think it'll come back. Holding Notre Dame. Brown, the man that got a hold of somebody.
It's a killer for Bob Davie. I mean, you run the option for the first time today, and you run it very well. Option is something you kind of hold in your back pocket because it's something the defense doesn't want to see. And you run it well, you pick up a lot of yardage, it forces the defense to make some adjustments. That is a big penalty against Notre Dame.
10-yard penalty for the holding brings the ball back to the 37-yard line.
But make no mistake, they'll go back to that option. Jim Colano, the offensive coordinator, says, I'll keep that in my back pocket. I'm going to run that some more.
First and 17 now after the penalty. Well, he keeps changing the ball, taking the long count, keeping him off balance. Don't give him a chance to come in and terrorize him. And he hands the ball to Spencer, the big fullback, and Jamie gets across the 42 to the 43. And it'll be second down and about 11.
Keith, what they're doing, and you alluded to Ron at the line of scrimmage, checking off and all that. He's getting the play, and he's getting to the line of scrimmage very quickly. So he's got a lot of time at the line of scrimmage. He can look at the defense, see if he wants to check, maybe fake check, fool around with them, and not let them get their blitzes timed so perfectly.
Second down, 11.
Control the line of scrimmage with your cadence.
He gets away from it, gets the pass off, and the pass is off the shoulder pads of Tony Driver, the freshman tailback. And he had some room.
Yes, he did. The ball was slightly behind him, but he should have caught it. No question. Things are not going well for Bob Davie. He just had that option, the penalty come back. Now he reads the blitz. There is nobody on Driver out in the flat. He could have run for 15, 20 yards before he got to anybody.
And so it is third and 11 with Autry Denson back on the field, a tailback for the Irish. with protection. Now they flush him out of there, and he's tripped and goes down. And it was Josh Williams that grabbed his shoe as it went by and tripped him. So the Irish will have to punt it away now. Third punt for Hunter Smith, and Charles Woodson will go back. And stand somewhere around his 15-yard line, inside the 15, to see whether or not Smith will kick it to him. .640 to go in the first half. No pressure. Good high driving kick that will carry all the way to the end zone, and it'll come out to the 20 where Michigan will have it first down. 53-yard punt. 6:32 remaining. 7-7 tie.
Score is tied at 7, and we went back and got one of the Michigan plays that they used against Colorado. One of their favorite running plays is 17 power. And off of that, they run a bootleg, fake 17 power, bootleg right, tight end across. Tight end Tubman on the left side is going to sneak across. Look at the flow of the linebackers and the defensive backs toward the play action of the ball. Now look at where Tubman is. He's up here. Breezy gets outside, throws it to Tubman. Look for Tubman to catch some passes. They'd run this play, Keith, earlier in the game, but they had a legal motion play. Look for them to go back to that play sometime during this game.
Chris Howard is the deep man, and that's Russell Shaw in motion. He takes Ivory Covington with him, and Greasy rolls out and throws underneath to Floyd, the big fullback, and he breaks a tackle, runs over another one, and it's first down Michigan up at the 36-yard line.
This is very similar to the play that we just drew up. The little wrinkle, Floyd, the big fullback, is a blocker. Watches, it's going to be a play action to the to our right side. Ryan rolls out. He has an option of going to the tight end or to the fullback in the flat. First down play off of your play action.
Make it the 37-yard line and a first down for the Wolverines. Inside, nothing doing. Chris Howard carries the ball. All kinds of big Irishmen in there, including Jimmy Friday and Grant Irons, two linebackers who filled the hole.
Grant Irons, 44, Keith. His brother played on this field last year in this game. Grant is a true freshman playing for Notre Dame. Jarrett, his brother, was a senior captain, a two-time captain of Michigan, and is here today watching his brother play. The
second and 10. Clarence Williams to the 41. So it'll be put down just outside the 41. ABC's College Football online live with all of the action from today's game. Scores, stats, highlights, all on America Online. The keyword, ABC Sports. Third down and 5 for Michigan. Down. He's up across the 45, but he's at least a yard and a half short of the first down as Ivory Covington, the corner on that side, made the tackle.
Yeah, both receivers were to the left side. Brian looked downfield. Notre Dame had good coverage, dumped it off into backfield, and hoped that the halfback could get past the first down, but Michigan's going to have to punt again.
So Notre Dame right now, considering all factors in the game, along the line of scrimmage, they're doing very well. 4:27 to go in the first half. Third punt for Benson, both of them 38 yards. And this one hits at the 10. They got a chance to kill it deep. And they do at the 1. So a good punt. Puts Notre Dame in a hole at their own 1-yard line. They put the ball on the 2-yard line for Notre Dame. It is first down at 4:13 to play in the first half.
Big series here, Keith. Michigan wants to hold them down here, force them to the punt. And if Notre Dame can just get some, eat up some first downs and some time and get it out and at least punt the ball away, they would have accomplished what they want to do.
But this is an opportunity for the defensive side of the ball to be very aggressive and make something happen. Well, let's see. They have not done much damage to the Irish offensive front so far. We've got seven of them out there right now. And now eight as Weathers moves up. And a penalty flag is thrown as Audrey Denson tries the right side and is stopped at about the 4-yard line. Jim Kimmeling, the referee. Michigan mistake. 5-yard penalty offside.
Drives coaches nuts, Keith. The penalties after you make a good play. We saw a couple early where Bob Davey was just not ready to crawl out of his skin. You got to remember, they're just 19, 20, 21-year-old kids.
It is now first and five as the ball comes out to the 7. That's a big difference. Defense over the ball for the Irish. Single back. Denson. Short of the line of scrimmage. Sam Sword. Number 93. It'll be second and 6 now from the 6.
Battle in the line. Sword, number 93, plays off the block of Dowdy. Nowhere for Denson to go. Sword leads this team in tackles.
He has 7 today. Copenhaver, linebackers up on the line of scrimmage. His way, then cut it back into the middle, and Denson is taken down by number 56, James Hall. But it's a first down. That's what the offsides did to Michigan.
Exactly. Exactly. They just want to make some first downs, and they know they're being conservative. They know that they're just running out the clock here before half, but don't be surprised if they go for a big play along here somewhere down the line.
From the 15, first down. Staying with the ground, staying with Denson to the 20. That's 5 more yards. So they're carving up the defensive front of Michigan. Chopping it out 5 yards at a time. Tonight at 7:30 Eastern on ESPN, Clemson and Georgia Tech in Atlanta at Grant Field. ACC road test for Clemson. Georgia Tech was in a very close knuckle breaker up at Notre Dame. They just barely lost to the Fighting Irish in South Bend. Clemson lost a tough game to Florida State. Tigers are in Atlanta tonight, taking on the Yellow Jackets on ESPN. Ball is given to Denson. Denson runs into number 93, Sam Sword. That'll be his 8th tackle of the first half. And they'll be looking at 3rd down and 3, long 3.
Equipment help from the official.
Michigan needs a defensive play now. Otherwise, Notre Dame's off the hook at 1:15 to go in the first half. Sword blitzing, pick him up. Inside, nobody. Big play, first down. Ken Barry, the fullback. All the way across the 40 and out to the 43-yard line. There is no question but what the story of this ball game is becoming, the offensive front for Notre Dame. Time call by the Irish at 1:02 to play in the first half in a 7-7 tie. Michigan's defense had a chance to pin them, but couldn't do it.
At the time of possession, Notre Dame doing what they want. So almost a little more than 7 minutes in their favor.
First down, the ball is at the 43-yard line for the Irish. 7-7 time. And now here's Paulus looking to go deep to the sideline. To Johnson, complete at the 32-yard line of Michigan. First down, Notre Dame.
Nice job by Ron Paulus. Looked down the center of the field to keep the safeties in the middle, and then just threw down right at us. Looks in the middle and then comes back to this side. Why he was doing that was to keep the safety, that one right there that just hits him, to the inside of the field. He's been around 5 years. Paulus, his 36th start here today. 9 of 11, 111 yards. But a good game.
Down at the Michigan 15-yard line. Malcolm Johnson.
Beat the offensive line has just given him all kinds of time to throw. Look at the huge gaping hole that he has to throw through. Kaczynski and Rosenthal.
Where's Weathers?
They're just. Jim Coletto said the other day that they're just going to throw away from. Woodson. Woodson kind of grabbing onto a jersey after he got hit in the head.
Benson. And they wrestle him down at about the 13-yard line. A couple of yards on the play and a timeout, Notre Dame. 30 seconds to play. They're obviously down in field goal range, but they have something else in mind.
Well, it's the offensive line that's setting the tone for this, Keith. Rosenthal and Kaczynski and Wisney and Pettigrew and Dowdy. And then Ron Paulus just taking him down the field.
Today we go back to 1981 as Smith Barney remembers number 11 Michigan hosting number 1 Notre Dame after a scoreless first quarter. Michigan quarterback Steve Smith finds Anthony Carter. A 71-yard touchdown, giving Michigan a 7-0 lead. And the Wolverines went on to win the game 25-7.
Carter, 71 yards.
Wisconsin, 27. Indiana, 26.
The football is resting just inside the 13-yard line of Michigan in possession of Notre Dame. Second down and 7, and you've got 30 seconds remaining. The Irish have one timeout remaining. They'll want to protect that probably in case they don't do something dramatic here so that they'll have a chance at a field goal.
And remember that this drive started on Notre Dame's 2-yard line. So they've come almost the length of the field.
It'll do one of two things. It'll give Notre Dame supreme confidence they can handle the Michigan defense in front, or it'll make the defensive people of Michigan mad in the damn hornet. They'll come out and do something.
I think probably both, partner.
On second down. Wallace wants to throw to the end zone. Throws underneath to Nelson. And Nelson down inside the 5 at the 2. First and goal. That stops the clock. They move the chains on the first down. And they hustle up to the line of scrimmage. 23 seconds remaining in the first half. Pickett. Now he's got time to talk.
Right. I don't think they called timeout. They just spiked it.
Just spiked it.
So he doesn't can't over there for too long and talk because the clock's going to start running. Yeah,
He's marking it ready for play right now.
So the clock is running. You've got 20 seconds left as Paulus has gone to the sidelines for a protracted conversation with Jim Coletto.
Yeah, this better be quick.
Now Michigan makes two defensive changes, and that really muddles up things. And Michigan gets nailed with a timeout.
What Notre Dame did is late, they put in their short yardage power offense. Michigan saw that. They wanted to get their short yardage power defense in, and they had to call timeout.
Wolverines have two remaining, and we've got 21 seconds remaining. Monday night at 9 Eastern time, ABC's NFL Monday Night Football. San Francisco at Carolina. What do you think of that one, Greece?
I like the 49ers, the way they're playing. Carolina has not been playing too good this year.
The defense has been the dominant story for the 49ers. They've played very, very well on the defensive side of the ball. They're in first place in the NFC West. Carolina's lost two at home, won two on the road. Kind of different.
They won every game at home last year. Carolina can't win one this year.
Hey, this team that's become the new team that's become a story is Jacksonville.
Uh-huh. Talking about Monday night. Our guys, Dan Dierdorf is here. Michigan graduates here watching the ball game. Your ass
off. They could use it.
Yes, they could.
Heavy team. 21 ticks remaining on the clock. Michigan with two timeouts. Notre Dame with one.
They're talking about what they want to do, what plays they want to call.
They've got it first and goal at the Michigan 2-yard line. Tony Driver, the freshman, is on the field. He's up.
He's there.
A full house. He's on the right side. Audrey Denson's on the left side. And the fullback is Ken Mary. And it's Driver. Driver found a huge hole over the left side of center with Kaczynski and Rosenthal and Dowdy doing their job, and he walks in. So they travel 98 yards to score the touchdown. Sansom for the extra point. Sophomore from Scottsdale, Arizona. Smith puts it down. The kick is up and good.
Notre Dame, Keith, going to some unbalanced line out in the field and then again on the goal line. Look at only two men to this side and four men to the left side of the center. They're going to run the ball over here right at us. Offensive line doing a great job of powering people. Some of them looking for people to block. Michigan just back in the end zone. Driver, the big back. He doesn't run into anybody until he gets across the goal line.
I'll take you back to an offsides by Michigan at the other end of the field that opened the door. And they went 98 yards and 11 plays in 3 minutes and 55 seconds.
Good point. That is a big drive right there, Keith. Huge drive. Momentum for Notre Dame going in at halftime. The mission's got to be regrouping.
So it's Clarence Williams, the deep man in the middle. And Jim Sansom will kick it off. Flag down where the tackle was made. And you got a mess as far as Michigan's concerned. Unless that first flag back up field has precedence. Eight seconds on the clock. Davey is not happy with some of his people. Mistakes, little mistakes like that, makes such a difference.
47 there, and the white is Matulis right there with the face mask.
Illegal formation on the kickoff, on the kicking team. Face mask on the kicking team. We will enforce 5 yards, re-kick.
Obviously, they want them to re-kick. The face mask call down here would mean nothing with only 8 seconds to go. You'd get one long pass, maybe, and that would be it. But you'd rather, I think, be in the position of having the possibility of a run back. Now, the question is, does Charles Woodson enter into the picture here?
Well, I don't think Notre Dame's going to let him have a chance to run it back, Keith. That's why they kicked the squib kick down the field. But, you know, Notre Dame is guarding against the run back. Of course, Michigan and Lloyd Carr would like to see something, but the chances of that happening...
Well, the people up here in the intermediate zone, the people in the middle would be the ones to have any kind of opportunity, and you've got tight ends. You've got two tight ends and a linebacker up there. I don't think the deep man will see the ball this time. He didn't see it the last time either. We're right between his legs.
Give him a glove.
So on the 30. If he kicks it on the ground, there is nothing in the book that says that one of the people up in front can't grab it. Either.
No, that's true.
But you don't see it very often.
I don't think they're going to have the speed to run by anybody.
Right. They put 4 seconds back on the clock, so now there's a total of 12 left to play in the first half. Ball fell off the tee. There's a very light little wind. Not a factor in what is happening on the field. The factor of what's happening on the field is the offensive line of Notre Dame.
Controlling the clock, Keith. Number of plays, Notre Dame has a heck of a lot more plays run than Michigan does.
Low, skimming, bouncing kick, and again, it rolls around. Williams gets a handle on it to let it go all the way through, and they take him down at the 26-yard line, and now you've got 8 seconds remaining. You get one play, possibly two. Tony Driver, the man who scored his first touchdown of his career, is on the kickoff team. He goes down and makes the tackle. So officially, it'll be snaps from just inside the 27 of Michigan.
Bob Davies got to be happy with things as they are right now, Keith. He's controlled the clock. His team came in maybe lacking a little confidence, a little shook up. And they're going to go out of this first half with, on a high as Woodson's in.
At the top of the picture, along with Marcus Knight and Clarence Williams. And here's Brian Greasy stepping away from the pressure and gets flushed out of the pocket and is taken down at the line of scrimmage. And that will do it. At halftime, Notre Dame leads Michigan by a score of 14-7.